The Indian rupees roller coaster ride is getting only rougher. It continued its free fall today, breaching new lows of 68 against the US dollar, spooking the markets in opening trade. The Sensex and the Nifty, however, recovered lost ground at closing, with the rupee inching towards 70 now. India Inc. is facing a tough time. The middle classes are all set to be directly hit by higher food and fuel prices. But the big question remains if the government can stem this slide anytime soon. The BJP now directly attacks the Prime Minister over the economy, demanding his resignation on moral grounds for the falling rupee and the sinking Indian economy.
देखिए जिस तरह से रुपया गिर रहा है और जिस तरह आज हालत बनी हुई, प्रधानमंत्री जी अर्थशास्त्री के नाते ही देश के वित्त मंत्री भी बने थे और प्रधानमंत्री जी अर्थशास्त्री के नाते ही देश के प्रधानमंत्री भी बने थे। अगर वो इकोनॉमी को संभाल नहीं सकते तो प्रधानमंत्री जी मनमोहन सिंह जी को पद पर बने रहने का कोई अधिकार नहीं है। अगर इकोनॉमी संभल नहीं रही तो प्रधानमंत्री कोई पॉलिटिकल एक्टिविटी नहीं कर रहे हैं, इकोनॉमी को संभालने की जिम्मेदारी उनकी थी वो नहीं कर रहे, तो फिर प्रधानमंत्री को अपने पद पर बने रहने का कोई अधिकार नहीं।
इज एक्सपेक्टेड and people are saying it will go down for the value of the rupee. This is all because of the total economic mismanagement, policy paralysis of Sri Manmohan Singh government. The Prime Minister and the Finance Minister must take the moral responsibility and they should really get out of their job because they have totally failed, they are clueless, they are totally helpless, they raise their hands and expressing helplessness. Earlier they used to blame America situation 2008 and 2009. Now also they are blaming. At that time they said there is a downslide in America, that's why the entire world is affecting. Now American dollar is picking up, now they are saying that is the reason. How can these two things go together? So that means these people have no clue at all, they have failed it miserably.
Well, we have definitely hit a turbulent period. There are strong headwinds, but we are not the only economy. It's a global development. Right from Brazil to Russia, to South Africa and the other countries, both the currencies and the markets have been adversely impacted. At the same time, there are some green shoots of recovery. United States, there the economic growth and the return of jobs is taking place. There are some signs of recovery even in UK, and that gives us hope that the present situation or the turbulence will be weathered and there'll be a turnaround. Nobody is denying that challenges are not there. The challenges should not lead us to despondency, because the macro fundamentals of the Indian economy are strong. Whether you look at the savings rate, the national investment rate, even our debt to GDP ratio, that has been brought down by 7 percentage points. And if markets have come down, the markets will go up also. Same is the case with the rupee. There is no reason why there should be panic.
Well, Anand Sharma, they're defending the government now. Even though it's completely cornered, the UPA government is hitting back at the opposition, which continues to criticize the government's economic policies.
There have been certain measures taken by United States in the last month or so, which is why currencies across the world, especially of emerging economies, have been under strain. It's been happening in almost all the developing economies, especially those in whose economy there's been who kind of large players today. And similarly, the rupee has also taken a hit, and there's been almost a 15% to 20% drop in the value of rupee. But as the finance minister quite clearly said, that A, the current rate does not really reflect the true value of the rupee, and ultimately it will settle down.
The government has lost control over the economy completely.
they are helpless before the forces of the market, and the result is that the market is behaving pretty much as it likes. So the rupee was 64 day before, it went to over 66 yesterday and has climbed to 68 now. The market, stock market, is in a free fall, the rupee is in a free fall. And I have been saying this now, not out of politics, that the only thing which will stabilize the markets and the rupee at this point of time is for the government to resign and to go for fresh elections.
See, firstly, let me tell you, the UPA promised liberalization, but what is really happening is not liberalization, it is hawalaization. And with the free fall of the rupee, what is really going to happen is the slush funds, all the slush money which has been kept abroad, this is the time it will be brought back, and this is a cause for major concern for all of us and the country. As far as the prices go, 130-140% the price of onions have gone up. We left this government in September, and you can imagine it's gone into free fall after that. From onion prices, petrol prices, diesel, fertilizer. It's a government which is a minority government, and it's just hanging in there, and the faster they go, the better, so this country can move on.
Basically, we have to instill confidence among the investors, both domestic investors as well as the foreign investors. Foreign investors, they are the net sellers and all. So even the domestic investors, though they are sitting with the surplus cash, they are not investing. That is mainly because of the government machinery is not functioning. No, that is why earlier I made a statement that the government is not in a position to implement the policies already, initiated. So more than the initiating the new policies or the fresh reforms package, the government should implement whatever the policy it has already initiated.
I think the biggest steps would be to ensure that some of these key issues around the way we would like to tackle our energy issues, the way we are looking at ensuring that the stuck projects actually get activated, what is the outcome therein, not enough to just clear at the CCI level, but what is the government doing to ensure that those projects actually begin to crank start and happen, and announce the projects that are actually now happening are going to be some ways where there's some order that returns to the system. At the end of the day, we need to create an enabling environment for industry, Indian industry.